हेलो।
प्रदीप,
यस
हाय प्रदीप, प्रशांत यार।
यस प्रशांत सर।
सो ओके, आई जस्ट वांट टू नो फोर ऑल हैव जॉइंड फ्रॉम चैनल पार्टनर लिस्ट। प्रदीप,
यस प्रशांत सर, टेल मी।
सो जस्ट लुक अराउंड इन द बोर्ड, हु ऑल जॉइंड फ्रॉम चैनल पार्टनर लिस्ट।
चैनल पार्टनर, कैन यू सी द पीपल इन द मीटिंग?
आई कैन सी बट आई कुड नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज हु ऑल फ्रॉम चैनल पार्टनर।
सेम हियर, सेम हियर। आई एम आल्सो नॉट एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज हु आर द चैनल पार्टनर्स। ओके, लेट इफ अतुल सर नोज।
Atul, can you please help us to find the overall from channel partner list?
I am also against that, but
most of the is in our domain.
Suppose the land rally, tell me, is Wednesday parent the word work? Land rally, then after I mean, either Kerala, then na, but upload the document. Samja. आईस गेट ला आलेला स्टेटस किंवा ड्यूटी पेमेंट चालेल
चॅनल पार्टनर
चालेल विल वर्क।
आय थिंक वी शुड स्टार्ट नाऊ।
ओके, I'm unable to find who all have joined. So let us take another 2 minutes of time and find out the way, Atul and Pradeep.
Okay. Hello Prashant sir, we should start now.
Just make it 1 minute, Pradeep. Let's see, just we'll start by 3 by 7 3 7, and we have to find how many of channel personnel attended and who are all not attended. Who are all not attended, we have to send some serious message on them, because channel partner role is quite different now. So maybe Atul can take care of that. So let us wait for another 1 minute. Okay, Pradeep.
Yes. I think now we will start. So good afternoon all. Welcome to today's discussion on Revolution Pi. And from this topic, we are here to know more about Revolution Pi. And where are the application areas? What are the target customers? And how it is? It can help in industrial automation field. So the today's agenda will be: first, we will see all the products available in Revolution Pi, and all the products and all variants. Then we will see why we should use Revolution Pi. Why only Revolution Pi? It's the best for IIoT. Then we will see programming sources, means what are the ways we can program the Revolution Pi. Then we will see one typical application which is related to IT/OT convergence and which is a need of IIoT, that we will also take a look. Then we will see about security. What are the security measures has been taken into account as this device is going to be connected to the internet. Then we will see the infinite possibilities with the Revolution Pi. So in this slide, you will get to know how best the product is for IIoT applications. We can call it as our Brahmastra for IIoT applications. And later we will see the use cases and real-time applications implemented with can be implemented with Revolution Pi. Then we will see the target customers whom we can approach to sell this product. Then there is one more thing which is called OEM brand labeling. If your customer is a big giant, then they might be interested in this OEM branding as well. So we provide OEM branding as well. So let's go through the Revolution Pi. There are basically two variants. As you can, basic two types are there, as you see in the yellow boxes, rectangular boxes. In first rectangular box, let me take a highlighter. In first rectangular box, the RevPi Connect and Core, these are the modular gateways. This means you can expand these gateways with your expansion cards, like your IO cards and your field bus gateways, like a Profibus, Profinet, the device net, and all that. We will take a look one by one as we proceed slide by slide. Then in second yellow square box, we are seeing here RevPi Compact and RevPi Flat. These are the non-modular gateways. It means we can't expand these gateways, RevPi Compact and Flat, with the expansion modules like our IOs, analog IO or digital IO or field bus gateways. So we will see where these in next slide we will see which gateway are good at which applications. And from this my explanation, you might have understood that this Connect and Core, which are modular gateway, you can be used in any field bus application. Like you can use it as a PLC as well, because it has the capability to expand with it, its IOs and field bus gateways. Whereas you in RevPi Compact and RevPi Flat, you can use this gateway for data collection or as moreover as an edge device or energy management or data collection purpose. You can use RevPi Compact and RevPi Flat, but it doesn't mean that you can't do the same operation with RevPi Connect and Core. Whatever you can do with Compact and RevPi Flat, you can do with RayoPy 4 and Connect as well. But they are, feature-wise, they are a bit different. We will take a look in next slides. Now we will see. Now in modular gateway, I have told that you can expand these gateways, RayoPy Connect and Core, with the I/O modules. So we have the following expansion modules: digital I/O modules, we have digital analog I/O modules, we have con expansion and field bus gateway as well. We will take a look in next slide, step by step with each gateway variant or expansion cards variants. First of all, we will take a look of DIO modules. So in DIO, we have three variants: digital input card, digital output card, and digital input and output. DI and DO has 16 channel each, whereas DIO module has 14 input and 14 output channel. So these Sripath sir, I think your mic is on. So then we have AIO module, which is analog input output module. The analog input output module has 4 analog input, 2 analog output, and 2 RTDs for temperature sensors. This is about the DIO and AIO, digital input output and AIO. Now we will see what are the gateway, field bus gateways are available with us. Here we can see the list of gateways on the screen, right from Profinet to DMX. All these gateways are very important to integrate your Revolution Pi system into the industrial field bus network or industrial network. You can use this Revolution Pi in any industrial field bus network with help of this RayoPy gateway. Till now whatever the expansion modules we have seen till now, that are only can be connected with only RayoPy modular gateways, that is RayoPy Core and Connect only. In case of RayoPy Flat and Compact, we can't use expansion modules. Now we have one more device, which is a RayoPy. You can see in the heading, RayoPy meets Codasys. Codasys is one of the best widely used platform for programming PLCs. As you all know that many PLC manufacturers are using Codasys as a platform to program their PLCs. Hence, in Revolution Pi also can be programmed with the Codasys. So with this module, you will get the inbuilt Codasys runtime environment, and you shouldn't need to pay any charges for licensing as well. And when you use this Codasys enabled Revolution Pi module, you are freely use this software with following field bus network, which is you can see on our slide: Profinet, Ethernet IP, EtherCAT, CAN Open, and Modbus. It means you don't need to purchase a physical gateway module when you are working with a Revolution Pi, which is enabled with Codasys. This is about the all the variants and all the RayoPy products. Till now, if anybody has any kind of doubts, please unmute yourself and please ask. So this will be a interactive session. If you understand this product, then only you can going to promote this product to customer or your customers. So till now, if you have any doubts, you can ask me now. So from this information related to product. Now the whatever the next slides are coming that are related to business point of view. That means which applications you can use for which application area or which customers you have to look for, what are and which industry you can pitch this product. So now you can ask the questions related to this.
Okay, thank you Pradeep. Prashant here again. Thank you for your at least first slides. Let us proceed further. So before that, I just want to understand. So I'll take 2 minutes. So Mr. Abdul and Bharadwaja from AS Automation, right? Sir, can you please respond to my, word?
Yes, sir. Yeah,
Abdul and Bharadwaja are from AS Automation. Okay, thank you,
yes,
sir.
Yes,
and Ajay K. Rana. Sir, can you please respond from where you are attending?
Explore Technologies, Greater Noida.
Okay, thank you, sir. Manish? Sir, can you please respond? Manish, sir? Okay, Vashita Jay. Sir, Vashita Jay, can you please respond to my word? Okay, however, there are few others I can see in the channel partner. Sir, thank you so much, whoever I have responded. Thank you for your time. So please understand this product completely. This is totally a unique product and also very good business in Indian market right now, because all kind of startups, all kind of software companies and all kind of automation companies are looking this kind of products right now. So if you can reach out those people deliberate way and if you explain in a proper way in your region, definitely you will be having good business, sir. That is the reason we wanted to make understand this product to you first. Please understand completely. If you have any doubt, please ask. And also business perspective and business point of view, definitely we'll let you know how to proceed further. Sir Manish, sir, please proceed, sir. Sir, we
yeah, sir, apne bhi. Hello.
Sir, your company name, please. Manish, sir.
Indexel Engineering Private Limited, Kota.
Okay, thank you, sir. Please proceed, sir. Do you have any questions, Manish, sir?
No questions.
Okay, I believe you understood that what I was telling, that this device is totally important device. Please reach out to your end customers, each and every single customer, and explain about this product. Definitely you can gain more business from this product. This is new and customer is not aware of this device completely. So you can reach out to the maximum customers irrespective of your basket range, but your focus should be software guys and automation people and some system integrators as well. So please understand this product completely. Anyway, Pradeep is going to explain which are all the major areas and the application part, and later in the end we will speak about the business point of view, sir, again. I was expecting most of the channel partner, but anyway, from next time it has to be happen. We'll take care further, sir. Pradeep, you can proceed if anyone doesn't have any question.
Okay, thank you, Prashant, sir. Next, now after taking a look at all the modular and non-modular base modules and the expansion modules, now we will see why we should use Revolution Pi. So what are the benefits of using Revolution Pi? As you can see, it is a open source Linux based controller, and when you are use open source hardware, then there are the advantages in price, and second one is, as it is Linux based, then you have the complete control over the controller. So there is no lock-in and no strings attached. This product can be used to communicate with any IT systems and all the hardware and all the PLCs, as you have seen that all the industrial protocol it supports. And when it comes to the IT, it communicates with any IT based system, any cloud, and all protocol, right, from MQTT to your REST APIs and your HTTP protocol. And there is a strong and fast effective technical community is behind this product, so you don't need to worry whatever your queries are there, you can put on the community or technical forums, you will get your answer very fast. So this is one of the reason you should choose Revolution Pi over other lock-in products or proprietary products. Now we will see what are the programming sources are there to program this Revolution Pi. As I already told, it is open source hardware, so, and it is Linux based, so you can program it any programming language, which you can see here, right from Python, C++, Java, or in Node-RED. And also, as we just seen, the Revolution Pi meets Codasys, means you can install Codasys with Revolution Pi on any product, as well as we have a special module which comes with the pre-built Codasys runtime environment. So you don't need to worry whether you are from IT side or automation side. If you are automation side, you are good to go with Codasys and Logicals. These are very similar with your traditional programming languages like Ladder and other programming languages. And if you are from IT background, then you are also good to go with Python, C++, and Java programming and Node-RED. So here you have various ways to program this controller. Then this is a typical application where you can see a typical IT-OT convergence. This is a RevPi Connect or Connect Plus, you can say, where you can get the two Ethernet ports. One port can be used for collecting your field bus data from industrial network, and other can be used to send that data to your IT systems through MQTT or OPC way. When I say it, IT systems, it can be your ERP system, it can be your cloud system, or it can be your database system. So after taking a look at this typical architecture, this is the best suitable product for your IoT applications, where it's generally this architecture will be there in your IoT applications. Now we will see the Revolution Pi security. As we just mentioned that this device is going to be connected with the internet or IoT purpose, then what are the security? So we use a crypto chip called Atmel security chip, ATECC508A. You can have the details from this link and all the documentation. So you don't need to worry about its security. Now we will see what are the applications where we can use this Revolution Pi Brahmastra for our IoT applications. And so Revolution Pi has infinite possibilities. It is a smart control unit. It is a PLC. As I already mentioned, it can be programmed with Codasys as well. And after taking a look at all the base modules in modular gateway or modular controller with its expansion modules, you can use it as a PLC as well. But please make a note that we can't use it as like a Siemens or Schneider PLC, because that can be used for higher IO count. But in Revolution Pi, when you use it as a PLC, there is a limitation for your IO count. Up to 100 or 130 IO count. If you have, please come to us. We will work it out. It will work as your PLC as well, and that too your IoT enabled PLC. whatever the data you are taking from your IOs, that can be used for your prediction, or you can monitor or control that from anywhere through internet. So this is very important point to note, that how you can use this as a PLC. And when you use as a PLC, there you have many other advantage over the other traditional PLCs. Next is, it is an IPC. So it can be used as a industrial PC, on dindrel mounted industrial PC. Because why it is IPC? It is a Linux based controller, and it has a HDMI port enabled. So after, you just have to connect the HDMI enabled monitor to the Revolution Pi, and it will act as your IPC. It can also be HMI. Whether it can be your HDMI enabled HMI, or you can access the same HMI with your browser as well. So it can be as a, you can access your HMI in a web browser. And it is a machine retrofit unit. You can put this unit in existing application, and you can enhance the quality, or enhance the features of the existing application. And this can be used as a predictive maintenance solution as well. And it is an AWS Greengrass unit. When I say here it is AWS Greengrass unit, this is a edge computing application of AWS, and you can go with any edge, you can do any edge computing here with Revolution Pi. You can do edge computing at on core, on premises, on Revolution Pi itself. You can go with AWS Greengrass edge analytics, Azure, IBM, any cloud edge analytics application you can go with. Then it is a cloud solution, it is a software platform, and it is a step 7 coupler. Step 7 coupler means you can send the data to Siemens PLC through a Revolution Pi. Please make sure that here we are going to get a business from a Siemens system integrators. If you take a look at all the points, it is a revolution, and it is one, and with this one unit you can have endless possibilities. Again, I mentioned it is a step 7 coupler. This one point, this can give us a business from a Siemens system integrator companies. Here how that I can explain later as well. And if you want to use, how you can use this RevPi as a with the Siemens controller, you just write us, we will get back to you in detail. Because it is not possible to explain everything in a single discussion. If you are interested, please raise a question at the end of the webinar, we will discuss in detail as well, if time permits. So now we will see the applications. Use cases and applications. Here you can see machine data login. You can get the machine data. You can read the machine data in Revolution Pi and send it to any cloud where your database is present. Otherwise, you can store your data in any network devices in MySQL. That means just keep in mind that this can be used as data logging purpose as well. So wherever data logging is required, you can promote this product there. So now here you can see in WTP plant in Germany, one of the customer has used this controller for their WTP plant monitor and control. What this unit is doing, this is a RevPi connect. If you let me take a pointer again. Here, as you can see in this module, here is the RevPi connect module is here, and this module is getting data from Siemens PLC and pushing this data to cloud for monitoring or triggering purpose. If something value, if something value exceeds, it can trigger or send notifications to a user. So this is the purpose of this RevPy unit, which is beside the Siemens PLC here in control panel unit. So this is one of the use case or application you can say. Then third is, as I already mentioned, you can use this as a RevPy as a PLC. Here you can see the DIO module is attached with the RevPy core unit, the very basic unit of RevolutionPy, and they are getting inputs, let it from push buttons or your limit switches or sensors. We are getting the inputs from input devices. Here you can see push buttons in the picture, and we will write a logic as per our application. If doesn't matter if you are from IT side or automation side. If you are automation side, you are good to go with Code Assist and Logic Add. And if you are IT side, you can write logic in Python, C, C++, even in Node-RED as well. So please make a note that you can use this as a PLC as well. But only thing is, the I/O count should be limited. Limited in the sense, if it is around 100 or 120 or 130, it's good to go. Then fourth is, you can see this is these are from OT side point of view. I have mentioned these use cases: WTP plant, data logging, and RevPy as a PLC. Now we will see the advanced way. That is how we can use this in image processing. How you can use this in a machine learning or AI, artificial intelligence. In this case, you have to find customers which are in IT side or a cloud platform provider companies. You have to look for that kind of companies or customers. Here in image processing applications, you can see the RevolutionPy, which is a Connect or Connect Plus, can be act as an edge collector and will collect the feeds in the sense real time data from cameras and do the analytics, and it will visualize on the dashboard as well. You can see many application for this application. You can see in smart CCTV camera. I will tell one more example where you can use this application in smart attendance system. As you already aware about the COVID situation, currently COVID situation, you have to just put a camera in front of your office when employee, and you have to get that fits in the RevolutionPy. And here you have to write the logic for image processing, and through this you can get to know who is present, who is coming, at what time, who is leaving at what time. All that you can write the logic as per your application, and same can be visualized in this dashboard. So this is image processing application, or you can say this is image processing is nothing but your AI as well, artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence means your RevPy is taking decision to recognize who is coming, who is going, at what time, and you can write your application as per your logic. So next is, this can be used as a data supplier for your IT systems like SAP system or PPS or production planning system. As you can see in this image on shop floor, there is a machine, there are sensors, they are sending data to the RevolutionPy. The RevolutionPy is sending that data to internet. On right side you can see the internet is there, and there is a database is also in cloud. So that data is being dumped in the database, which are on cloud, and whatever devices are connected with the internet, or a display or PC or a tablet, you can access the data on that tablets or mobile phones. So these are the typical applications. When you sell this product or promote this product, you will get a wide range of customers. There is no any limitations. You can go with IT customer, you can go with OT customer, automation customer, system integrator, even the IoT hobbyist or the people who are doing a DIY project, like a do-it-yourself project for a home automation or a building automation system, that all are should be our customer for Revolution Pi. Next thing, now we will talking about the target customers. First is IT companies like cloud platform provider or smart solution provider. When I talk about smart solution provider, means the people who are doing BMS, smart building, smart home automation, or smart irrigation, smart agriculture, smart energy management. All these companies are the target potential customer for us to sell the Revolution Pi. When I told you this can be used as a PLC, so machine builders where the IO count is around 100, there you can use this as a PLC as well. When we are using with as a PLC, you should keep in mind that this can be used. There might be questions from your customer that we can't do this, we are not familiar with Python. Then you should able to tell them that this can be programmed with your codices or logicals as well, which is very similar to the traditional PLC programming. So these are your target customers. You can use these in a process automation industry for various purposes. You can use this product in process industry for data collection, as we seen in a previous slide, that Revolution Pi as a data collector or a data provider to your IT systems like SAP and or cloud systems. In energy sector for the same, factory automation industry for the same. We can't use as a PLC in a factory automation or process automation as a this Revolution Pi as a PLC, but we can definitely use there as a edge device or a data collector purpose or a data supplier means getting data from your OT side and push or supply that data to your ERP system. On further, they will take this data for their decision making purpose. This is where your role of the Revolution Pi comes into the picture, and these are the target customer. You can control panel manufacturer is also a customer for our Revolution Pi. And as I said, focus on Siemens system integrator, because it is very easy to read Siemens PLC data from Siemens PLC to Revolution Pi, then next push data to a cloud. And also you can read field bus data in a RevPi, and then you can send that to Siemens. That is also possible. So that's why I am mentioning here repeatedly, focus on Siemens system integrator. You just get the customer, we will have a meeting with them, we will say where perfectly this product is suitable for Siemens and their IoT projects, and remote solution provider as well. When I talk about the Siemens system integrator and remote solution provider, why I am talking this, there is a two license available in Revolution Pi. There is a tie-up with Siemens and Kunbus for coupler communication, and there is a tie-up between TeamViewer and Kunbus again for a remote solution purpose. So these are the two applications we can achieve very easily and very short span of time. So you should focus on point 8 and point 9, who are remote solution provider and Siemens system integrator. So this is OEM brand labeling. I have told in my first slide itself that when you are dealing with any tech giant or big giant company, and if you want to have here his own logo, his own color, and customized software, everything is possible under this OEM brand labeling. If any customer is there like this, please connect with them and get back to us. We will provide more details on this. So in nutshell, this is as I already said, this is a Brahmastra for us, for our IoT needs, our IoT applications, with all its expansion modules and gateways. This RevPi offer the right tools. Almost every project, you can use this Revolution Pi. So they are basically with the Swiss Army News of industrial automation. Here, Swiss Army News means it is a one device for multi-purpose things. You can use. This is a, so in nutshell, I can say this is a Brahmastra, your Brahmastra for your IoT applications and or your automation projects. Till now, if you have any doubts, now you can free to ask me if you have any doubts till now. If you have any questions related to this discussion, whatever I told, you are now you can now unmute yourself and ask me.
सर इसमें नेट कनेक्टिविटी के लिए सिम का स्लॉट है क्या?
नहीं, इसमें सेल्युलर कनेक्टिविटी नहीं है, लेकिन आप सेल्युलर राउटर यूज करके सेल्युलर इंटरनेट सेल्युलर राउटर से आप इंटरनेट अरे उपाय को दे सकते हो।
सर फील्ड में, लेकिन राउटर कहाँ से आएगा? वहाँ तो
नहीं, राउटर पैनल राउटर आपका रहेगा। अभी आपको इंटरनेट चाहिए, फील्ड रिमोट साइट है आपकी और वहाँ पे इंटरनेट नहीं है, तो आप सिम कार्ड से इंटरनेट दे सकते हो सेल्युलर राउटर को, और राउटर इंटरनेट देगा रिवोल्यूशन पाई को। अगर आपके पास ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग इंटरनेट है तो आप डायरेक्टली राउटर से दे सकते हो। आपका अगर
डायरेक्टली फील्ड पे तो एग्जिस्टिंग इंटरनेट होता ही नहीं है ना सर, वहां तो सिम कार्ड ही लगा सकते हैं, और कोई पॉसिबिलिटी होती नहीं है।
तो इस केस में सिम कार्ड लगा सकते हो, तो आपको राउटर में सिम कार्ड लगाना पड़ेगा। मतलब जो राउटर में इंटरनेट आएगा वो सिम कार्ड से आएगा, और राउटर से रेवपाई को इंटरनेट आएगा। So this is how it goes when it comes to the cellular connectivity. Aur koi question aur kuch doubt related to IoT, industrial IoT, data logging? Even I said this can be used for your data supplier for your IT systems like SAP cloud.
Isme data logging ke liye DNP3 protocol hoga kya sir?
डेटा लॉगिंग कौन सा प्रोटोकॉल?
DNP3
प्रोटोकॉल नहीं, डेटा लॉगिंग मतलब आप अभी आपको डेटाबेसिस में डेटा स्टोर करना है, और आपके जो भी फील्ड बस
डेटाबेस में नहीं करना है, हमें इसी मॉडेम में करना है, मतलब आपके आईओटी में।
हां, ऑनबोर्ड इसका अप टू 32 GB स्पेस आपको मिलेगा, तो 32 GB में आपका डेटा लॉगिंग कर सकते हो।
मतलब अगर मेरा नेट कनेक्टिविटी चली जाती है, और तो जैसे ऑटोमेटिक नेट कनेक्टिविटी आती है, तो मुझे जितना भी डाटा लॉस हुआ है वो मेरे को मेरे इसका सर्वर पे मिल जाएगा?
हाँ, अभी समझो आप डाटा कहीं दूसरे सर्वर पे पुश कर रहे हो इंटरनेट से, और आपका इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी रुक जाता है, तो टेम्पररीली रेवपाय में डेटा स्टोर होगा। जैसे आपका इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी वापस आ जाता है, जो भी स्टोर हुआ है वो वापस आपके डेटाबेस में स्टोर करेगा। So, करेगा मतलब इसके लिए हमें प्रोग्रामिंग करनी पड़ेगी। दिस वे वी कैन प्रोग्राम दिस गेटवे।
तो सर ये कौन से प्रोटोकॉल पे डाटा देगा हमें?
अभी मैंने जो एक्सप्लेन किया है कि ये मॉडबस पे देगा, मॉडबस TCP, मॉडबस RTU, और एक्सपेंशन गेटवेज भी है जहाँ पे मेरा पेज
नहीं, वो जो मेरा जो डाटा स्टोर हो रखा है, जो नेट के जो नेट कनेक्टिविटी जाने पर स्टोर हुआ है, वो डाटा किस फॉर्मेट में देगा हमें वापस से, किस प्रोटोकॉल पे देगा?
आप डाटा एक्सेल में स्टोर कर सकते हो, CSV फाइल में स्टोर कर सकते हो, आपको किस फॉर्मेट में चाहिए?
सर हमें स्टोर डाटा वापस से उसी फॉर्मेट में चाहिए जैसे जो लाइव आ रहा था, DNP3 प्रोटोकॉल बेसिकली।
नहीं, एक्चुअली DNP3 प्रोटोकॉल सपोर्ट नहीं करता है। अभी यहाँ पे गेटवे जितने दिख रहे हो ना, इस गेटवे में से डेटा आता है तो इट कैन सपोर्ट DNP3, इट वोंट सपोर्ट DNP3। उसके लिए हमारे पास
डेटा को किसी में देगा सर ऑटोमेटिक बाद में?
क्या
स्टोर डेटा को CSV में देगा बस ये?
हाँ, CSV में भेज सकता है, CSV में, एक्सेल में, और अगर डेटाबेस सिस्टम अभी आजकल IT में जाते हो तो वहाँ पे डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम रहते हैं, जैसे आपका MySQL है, MSSQL है, तो टेबल फॉर्मेट में आपको डेटा मिलेगा। अगर आपका DNP3 पे एप्लीकेशन है तो हमारे पास दूसरा गेटवे है, SG गेटवे। तो आपका कुछ इंक्वायरी है तो मैं कंसर्न चेतन सर है, वो आपसे बात कर सकते हो, चेतन सर से, जो कि SG गेटवे का देखते हैं।
अच्छा,
जहाँ पे आपको एनर्जी रिलेटेड सब प्रोटोकॉल मिलेंगे, DNP3 मिलेंगे, IEC 61850 मिलेंगे, एनर्जी रिलेटेड सेम प्रोडक्ट विच इज स्पेशली फॉर स्मार्ट ग्रिड और एनर्जी इंडस्ट्री। हेलो, I hope ki this clear your doubt.
Yeah, okay.
So our kuch questions.
Yeah, Pradeep.
Yes.
Sir, it is configurable, no, actually.
Yeah, it is configurable. You can configure your IOs,
your through cable. which means communication software we have to use for the communication for this configuration. Any software is there for communicating to this, yes, or is it directly?
There is a software. Yes, there is an inbuilt software called PicTree where you can configure your hardware, your IOs, and your field bus gateways.
Okay. Means that through this we can configure whatever the cloud system is, that also we can configure with this.
Yeah, for hardware configuration there is inbuilt software called PicTree. For related to sending data in cloud or sending data to database system, for that you have to do programming. As I say, you can do program in Python, or you can use Node-RED, or you can use Codasys as well.
But we have to send to cloud means we have to use any network for that purpose, or any optional in this inbuilt, is there any means to communicate with the internet or GSM or what actually?
To send it to cloud means there will be a communicate with the any cloud, there will be a protocol. Maybe it is HTTP protocol or MQTT or OPC. So the Revolution Pi supports HTTP, MQTT, OPC way all. Just you have to do programming there in order to send that data to cloud. That will be a programming part.
Okay.
Sending data to cloud is a programming part.
Okay. Okay. That program guide also is available. This.
Sorry. Can you repeat?
The programming guide also with this available, or how it is?
There is a forum is available for all your technical queries, and some tutorials are also there. I can share the link in chat box for your forum and technical tutorials. Otherwise, we can also help you out.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Apart from this, any other question? If अभी किसी के पास कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं है तो अभी एक आज एक एप्लीकेशन किया था मैंने, जो कि मैं सिमेन से डेटा रीड कर रहा था और वो MQTT पे डेटा पुश कर रहा था. अभी अपने पास 10 मिनट टाइम है, अगर आपके पास कोई सवाल नहीं है तो यू कैन हैव दैट डेमो एज वेल. आई विल शो दैट डेमो.
या प्रदीप, यू कैन हैव ए लुक. एक्चुअली यू कैन प्लीज प्रोसीड फॉर दैट. मीनवाइल आई विल जस्ट हैव ए वर्ड. Thank you so much for those questions, sir, Manish and others. See, basically we UL group always seek our channel partner should be a technocrat, like how we are learning. So we no need to be just for a business guys. So we should be a technocrats, where if you sit in front of your customer, you should be having an idea of all the subjects what UL group basket range. So the reason we are trying to give as much as all the information about the devices and also a basket range, so that you can convey to your customer. This is also a unique device where we are selling in Indian market. And also it gives you a new ideas where you, if you go to the startups, they'll be seeking for new ideas. So please promote this device to them so that definitely they'll get some new ideas, and also your team definitely can get new ideas by using this device. This is very reasonable, and as Pradeep said, this is completely IIoT device. So whenever you are hearing a IIoT, just remember Revolution Pi. Okay, and this meeting or this discussion is mainly to focus this particular product to your basket range, sir, your customer basket range. We may come back to you maybe after a week to ask how many customers you have sent a marketing or maybe a direct mailer, and how many inquiries like that. So please respond in a deliberate way. So we will support you if any technical clarification required from your customers. Please understand this subject. If you required again to explanation, please come back to us. we are there to explain you in a better way. So let just have a look last practical explanation. Finally, you can conclude, sir. So this is Prashant. You can reach me out anytime for any sales business or sales strategy. And also, I may come back to you to have a customer basket range from you, sir. Thank you so much.
Hello. Here, if you are from Siemens background, you could easily relate that this is a TI portal, and I have program already. And in the camera, you can see the setup. I have connected the Siemens 1200 PLC with the Revolution Pi, and I'm accessing the Siemens data through Node-RED. Here, now you can see in a simulation as well as and in a LED in a onboard digital output LED of the Siemens as well. Let's see. I will turn on LED from here. This is a. Now you can see in simulation the things are the output Q0.0 is high. And in here you can see on physical device the respected LED of Q0.0 is also high. And this dashboard you can control from anywhere. Now I turn off the LED. You can see the Q0.0 is turned off now. So you can see the now what I did is I have reading the data from Siemens PLC through Step 7 protocol suite, and I'm sending the data to MQTT. I have used the local MQTT broker here. If you could see this my screen, this is my MQTT broker I am using. This is the IP address of my broker. So this kind of application you can do, and if you have any technical queries related to this, I hope you find this application interesting. And suppose you need to have any details how we can achieve this, for that we have a technical forum and where all the bright minds who are using this Revolution Pi here you can get help from them. You can I will give the link of Revolution Pi forum. Revolution. So I will tell you this is a Revolution Pi website, and here are success stories. And here is a forum. Here are all the questions are already. You can, if whatever doubts you have, whatever queries you have, you can register here. And after login, you can ask your own questions. You will already there are a lot of people are interacting with this, asking questions on this forum, and many people are giving answers here. All the questions related to the Revolution Pi are available, right? From Logicals, Node-RED, Teamweaver, Codasys. This is from a software point of view, hardware point of view also. All the questions are already asked. Around 10,000 questions are being asked till date. So what you have to do, you have to just create your you have to register on website and ask the questions.
Okay, so that is basically a forums platform where you can interact with your colleagues, like your related companies or maybe a management of Kunbus. So it's a very user friendly platform you can utilize, sir. You can convey to your customer. And the last point which I want to mention to onboard people is coming 28th we have a webinar on the same topic, sir. So before that, we wanted to convey to all our channel partners. So we have taken to you on board. So please, we will send a subject. We will send you the invitation of webinar. Please circulate to all your customers. So just get them on board. They can understand more on this product. So maybe another 2 to 3 days, you will get an invitation where you can forward it to your end customers. And also we need some kind of support from you. like saying that this how many emails we have sent, how many response we got. So like that, we need some support from your side, sir. So we'll come back to you for that. So thank you, Pradeep. I believe the session was good. I believe this way we can conclude it.
Yes, yes.
Chetan, now, Chetan, if you have any concern or if you have any suggestion, please go ahead, Chetan.
Summarize the things is like we having the industrial 4.0 gateway. It's a free to use, no software or the license key is required to use this gateway. So like summarize the things like if you are having the go to the industry and somebody say that I want to fetch the data from the controller and send it the data somewhere the clouds. So the first the image comes in front of your mind like yes, we have the industrial 4.0 gateway in our product basket range, so that in such a way you can promote this product in the industry and you can together we can grow in the industry 4.0.
okay, thank you so much. So Abdul, Ajay, Bharadwaj, Manish, Vashita, and many of you, thank you so much for your time. So hope you understood. If definitely you can come back to us by having plenty of questions to make us more experienced. Be careful and please circulate this device catalogs to your end customers. Thank you so much, each and everyone. Thank you, Pradeep, for your time, and you made a presentation to us where we can learn more. Thank you.
Pradeep, do one thing. You just put up the link in the chat box. That is
Yeah.